In the feedback amplifier, the negative feedback amplifiers, closed loop gain, AVF is reducing, but this is increasing, so these two will not come. We want to match only the two options. So series means input resistance is increasing, shunt means input resistance is decreasing. So you see this is directly given. So for the first one, option is A. For the second one, option is B. So directly they are given a matched condition, right? And next question is, to obtain very high input output impedance, fourth question, to obtain very high input and output impedance, what type of feedback we should have? First one is voltage series, option B, current series, option C, voltage shunt, option D, current shunt. So what is the input and output impedance, especially high input and output impedance? We know series means R is increasing, voltage means R naught is decreasing, so current means R naught is increasing. So to get both high, we must have current series feedback amplifier. Option B is the right answer. So these are the questions asked in the topic input and output resistance. And the third portion of GET questions in feedback amplifier is effects of negative feedback amplifiers. So effects of negative feedback amplifier. So what are the effects come in introducing feedback in the negative feedback in the amplifiers? First thing is, we discussed many times that gain reduced to maintain stability, which means stability is increased. Second, bandwidth is increasing. Third one, decreased noise. Fourth one, decreased distortion. And the last one is, of course, we know input and output impedance can be modified by using the term 1 plus beta L. This will change your input and output impedance, either increasing or decreasing, right? So these all are the important advantages or effects of negative feedback in the normal amplifier circuits. And by using this, what are the questions asked in the gates? So first question is, the negative feedback amplifier, negative feedback amplifier option A improves SNR at input side, option B improve SNR at output side, C does not change SNR, and option 4 or option D is reduce distortion. Just by looking at the option, you can say the last option, reduce the distortion, is the one of the effects of the negative feedback amplifiers. So second question is, negative feedback in a closed loop, negative feedback in closed loop amplifier, second question, option A, reduce gain amplifier, actually the question is, does not Note this line. Does not reduce gain. Option B, reduce bandwidth. Option C, improve disturbance. Disturbance rejection. Option D is reduce sensitivity to the parameters. Parameter variation. So, among all this, feedback amplifier does not what actually. So normally when you have a negative feedback amplifier, gain is reduced. So this option will not come because this is does not make change. But this will make change, reduce the gain. Similarly, the negative feedback amplifier increases the bandwidth. This one increases the bandwidth. So this may be possible. Increases the bandwidth, not reduces the bandwidth. And third option, increase the disturbance rejection, which means distortion may be rejected. That is improving. Yes, suppose it is doing, but option is does not. So this may not come. And they reduces the sensitivity to the parameters. See, look at these three options. All these things are feedback amplifiers with negative feedback. They actually does these three things. It reduces the distortion, reduces the sensitivity, reduces the gain, but increases the bandwidth. But here option is what the feedback amplifier does not do means this bandwidth will not reduce, it actually increase. So option B is the right answer. And last two questions from this thing. And question is, an amplifier has open loop gain is AB. Open loop gain AB is equal to 100. Lower cutoff frequency, I will write in terms of F1L. Lower cutoff frequency is equal to 100 Hz. Upper cutoff frequency, I will write F2H or F1H, let us suppose. F1H is equal to 100 kilohertz. Feedback factor beta is equal to 0.99 is connected to the amplifier. Then what is the new cutoff frequencies? New FL and FH. And let us suppose this is F2L and F2H. What is the new bandwidth? So according to the negative feedback amplifier advantage, bandwidth is increasing. So let us suppose this is the figure. This is the bandwidth, means this bandwidth is now increased. It means something like this. Compare these two figures. This is previous F1H, and now this is the new F2L, and this is F2H. Just by looking at the graph, you can say that F1 value is reduced and F1H value is increased. Depends, when you go left side, it approaches to zero, right? When you go from here to right side, the value is increasing according to the graph. So F1 is reduced and F1L is reduced, lower cutoff frequency is reduced and higher cutoff frequency is increased. It means, I told you, if something is reduced in the negative feedback amplifier, it is because of 1 plus AB beta. If something is increases, it is also because of the same factor. So F1L is reducing this side. So automatically F2L is equal to F1L divided by 1 plus AB beta. So division means it reduces. So we can solve this. Solve here. So F2H is equal to F1L value is 100 divided by 1 plus AB value is 100 into beta is 0.99. 0.99 into 100 is 99 plus 1. This is 100. So 100 get cancelled, you get 1 Hz. F2H is 1 hertz. So F2H, sorry, L, F2L is 1 hertz. Similarly, F2 means it is increasing. So when something is increasing, it is because of the same factor. So F2H is equal to F1H into 1 plus beta AV, it is nothing but 100. So 100. So F1H value is over here. It is also 100 into 10 to the power 3 into 100. Now see, 3 zeros, 2 zeros, 1 zero. So you can write 10 into 10 to the power 6 hertz, or you can write 10 mega hertz. So the upper cutoff frequency, which means no new cutoff frequency, is 10 into 10 to the power 6 hertz. Or you can write 10,000 kilohertz. Either of the way, you can write the answer. So this is the new cutoff frequency. Because of the negative feedback amplifier, bandwidth is increased. And the next question, using the same method. So what are the things given? Yes, an amplifier has open loop gain. Again, open loop gain. AV is equal to 100 and RI is 1K. R0 is equal to 100. I guess this is 100K. I missed this. Okay, let us see this. No, not 100K. It is 100. And feedback factor is 0.99. Is connected to an amplifier in voltage series feedback. Find new input and output impedance, and find new RI and R0. So with the feedback, we may write RIF, R0F. So first thing is voltage series feedback amplifier. So series connection means, I said RI is increasing, of course. Then voltage means R0 is decreasing. So voltage means R0 is decreasing. You can refer the first table. So again, it is very simple. If something is increasing, it is because of the factor 1 plus AV beta. If something is reduces in the negative feedback amplifier, it is also because of the 1 plus AV beta. So simply, for the increment, you multiply with this term. So RI value is 1 into 10 to the power 3, 1K. So 1 plus AV is 100 again 0.99. So this value is again 100. So you will get 100 kilo ohm. Options I type later. So 100 kilo ohm is the input resistance. And for output resistance, R0F is equal to R0 divided by 1 plus AV beta. What is R0? It is 100 divided by 1 plus AV beta is also 100. So you will get 1 ohm. So options are, option A is 10 ohm and 1 ohm. Option B, 10 ohm and 10K. Option C, 100K and 1 ohm. Option D is 100K and 1K. So what is the answer? RIF is 100K RI, so 100K. RRF is 1 ohm, this is 1 ohm. So option C is the right answer. So these are all the important and gate questions asked from 1990s to till now. And 2018 gate question, they have asked what is the input and output resistance of trans impedance. So remember this also, in 2018 it is asked, trans impedance input and output resistance, transimpedance. So transimpedance is nothing but trans resistance. Clear? And if it is given in terms of trans admittance, it is nothing but trans conductance. Right? So you can get input and output resistance for these two from the table which I gave in the beginning of the class. So likewise, you can solve all the gate problem. If I missed any questions, kindly use this information to solve the gate questions on the topic feedback amplifiers. Again, I'll tell you, before doing this gate questions, kindly watch 2 to 3 videos which I uploaded previously. That will be really helpful to understand the concept. Once we understand the concept, we can easily solve the gate questions on the feedback amplifiers. If this video helpful, kindly like, subscribe and share. Thank you.